Hello, this is a very brief comparison between a Faurig 122 silent system and a Faurig 133, very similarly priced pianos. Faurig 133 is their top range upright piano. Now the Faurig 122 silent system, in our opinion, is one of the very best because the hammer can travel nearly to the string. The hardly impedes. The silent system in a lot of pianos means that the hammers can't travel as far. These are travelling to within about 3 millimeters of the string before they set off, and so you get good control on soft playing. Having said that, the 133, it does have better control. It's regulated really, really finely. This really is a very high quality piano. I regard this piano as one of the best uprights, as good as a piano twice its price, literally. And the tone to me is much warmer. This is a European sound, much warmer than the Far Eastern tone, and really rich bass. The 122 has also got very angled bass strings. If you compare that with some, for instance, the Yamaha U3, the angle isn't nearly as great. So actually the bass strings here are actually longer than the U3, even though the piano's a bit shorter. This is the bass on a U3. And the bass on a 122. Which is far richer and warmer. And the 133. Obviously longer strings, fabulous bass. Now while the bass is really important, the tone that's the most important is the middle area, because that's the bit you're playing the most. The touch and tone on this piano, this is a 122, is very, very pleasant indeed. Very warm tone, very even touch and responsive. Allows you to play really quietly and has plenty of volume too. The 122 also has some excellent silent features. It has many instruments that you can select, a lot of different piano sounds, different instruments. You can select the metronome, start, stop for recording, etc. So it's everything you'd expect it to be, and really high quality pianos they are as well. And now the 133 Faurig is the best upright piano that they do, and is one of the very best. It has a warmer tone, in my opinion, than pianos of double the value. And it's immensely refined action. Now, if you are thinking of silent pianos, you might also think whether you really need a silent piano or whether you just need one with a practice pedal on. Because if we put the practice pedal down on this one, this is normal playing. And with the practice pedal. So obviously that is much less intrusive. Now, if you need a silent piano, obviously you need a silent piano, but practice pedals on upright pianos are made so that you can practice, and it's really quite a soft and not an intrusive sound. That's with the practice pedal taken off. Thank you very much for listening.